I'm Jeff Redshaw of Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com. Well, today, we're going to address the governor. So this is our two-barrel governor carburetor off of the 1957 low-cab forward. I really don't want to have to go through this, but I'm going to have to go through this. Sometimes you just got to do what you don't want to do. So, fuel filter. I don't want to take this apart. Mostly because this is probably going to leak. I don't want it to leak. I know it's not the governor, but it's got to be done. We got no vent on the bowl, which means it was kind of exposed. Kind of, sort of, maybe, but not really. Which way are you going to go? Go one way or the other. Let that out. All right, we'll get to that later. So, what else we got on here? A clip that I don't have a tool for.
One of them squish it bendy kind of clips. It's permanent.
Well, it's not permanent.
I'll come back when I get all the screws out.
Governor operation. Your throttle shaft is offset. If any of you guys have ever worked on older carburetors where the throttle shaft is right in the center and you don't have a throttle return spring on it and the engine's running, as soon as you crack that throttle open, it goes right to the wide open throttle. On this, anytime the engine is running, if you open the throttle on it and let go of it, even without a return spring, this throttle will slam shut because it's putting more pressure on the wide side. So, in here you have a spring, and what will happen is, because the air movement is trying to force the throttle plates closed, it's being counteracted by the spring in here. And that's what's actually opening the throttle plates. So what happens is, at low RPM, you have a lower amount of airflow than you do at high RPM. So if you slam this thing wide open throttle, the spring tension is holding the throttles open. The air pressure is trying to push the throttles closed. So the faster the engine turns, the more air moves through here, and the more air that moves through here, the more it closes the throttle plates and it mitigates the throttle opening. Doesn't minimize it. Prevents the engine. This is the 1950s rev limiter. Why, nothing happens. It must be stuck. Well, this one is far simpler than the other design they had. You can change the tension on the spring here and moving it to a different location. That one's right in the middle. So I don't know what this thing is and why it has a zerk in the end of it. That's probably just to plug the hole. Oh, I see. There's a place where a piece of linkage rod is supposed to go in there. So there's got to be a diaphragm on here with a linkage rod on it. And that would have been a vacuum line. But the vacuum passage is probably right here. All right, this does not help us. So basically what will happen is this governor will not work. Well, back to taking it apart. The gasket is preserved. Oh no, the gasket is not preserved. I ain't never had one come off that easy. I'll take it. One split in the gasket.
But it's in the air horn. It's okay.
There's spider webs inside now. Needle is not stuck. power plunger's a little sticky. Thought I was going to find more than just that. Nice wasp nest. Little mud bugs. Well, that will all clean up with water. Never mind the background noise, it's just rain. Now underneath this should be the accelerator pump check valve. Discharge check valve. That's stuck in there pretty good. Alright, just leave it there. Bug nest. The bug nest monster. Ruh-roh! Why? That is the gasket hanging out into the throat on both sides. That is a rough idle just waiting to happen. I don't want to put a carb kit in this thing. I don't want to. And the jet comes loose as he drops it on the filthy bench cover. Just a bug wing. Fuel wells. Why, this spider is in here and still alive. Rude awakening, huh? We're finding them all. Actually, looks like it just shrunk. Now I gotta get a kit. I don't want to get a kit. No, no, no! Inspect your needles. You got a little spot you can catch your thumbnail on. Well, I've got a big spot you can catch your thumbnail on. Somebody couldn't get the carburetor adjusted. I can't imagine why. Alright. Stuck throttle plates. I guess I'll get the gum now off here. Drop this in some muriatic acid, maybe. Why? That's no good. Or is it? Oh, it is good. I popped the throttle plates open. Scared me for a second. That's what I was talking about. The spring pressure holds the throttle. That's what opens the throttle. As you see now, when I move this, the throttle plates actually work. So it's the spring tension that opens the throttle plates. I wish I had this rod. I'd really like this governor to work. Remember how that went on there? I don't.
Just kidding.
Well, we still need to remove that crud. And I think I'm just going to give it a muriatic acid bath. Give that a few minutes. Let's see what we got here. After about 10 minutes. Or no, 15 minutes. Looking pretty pretty. Let's dunk it the other way. And wait. Okay, so another 10, 15 minutes later. Oh, it's beautiful. Blast of air. There. Now ain't that pretty. So now that we are into full-blown carburetor overhaul, not by any choice, mind you, it's time to take care of some things. I do not like these clips. I have never liked these clips. But that's how you can get them off. Let's see. Where's the big fat flat screwdriver? Nope. It's just a no want to work. There we go. After mutilating it. Power piston. Rinse the bug nest out of here, and this will be ready for the chem dip.
It's dipping.
Just big enough.
There's no aroma.
That doesn't smell like chem dip. It smells like butyl cleaner. Like, and it's bubbly. Have they gone and changed chem dip on me? This was the real stuff. Danger, harmful or fatal if swallowed. Vapor harmful, causes eye and skin burns. Combustible mixture. That's the real deal. Eye and skin irritant, harmful if swallowed. That can't be any good.
I wanted to put this in there, but I gotta get this ball out of here. Maybe if I tap it down a touch. It will come up. It worked. Sprang. So I read a pump check ball. That should be all there is to it. Except, of course, a bug nest down in there.
Well, in my zeal to remove the bug nest, I think I may have created a problem. Because
this is your accelerator pump, well, but there's another depression down in here. That's where the fuel goes into, and another check ball is supposed to be in there.
Because you need a check ball to prevent the backflow of gasoline back to the accelerator pump from the discharge nozzle. And you also need another one to keep from pushing gas out where it has to come into the fuel pump well. I believe we have a mess here.
Okay, I'm thinking of a different carburetor because this one has the slot inside of the... This one has the slot in the side here. And the fuel level comes up above that, so the fuel comes in over the top of the accelerator pump, not through the bottom.
Okay. Let us check item number one. There's really no carbon buildup on this thing. Or varnish. It's basically just dust and bug nests. So... That should be ready.
Okay, these are your secondary venturis for drawing fuel into the airstream. Give them a rinse and blast and throw them in the bucket. Well, we do have a bit of corrosion. I kind of corroded the tip off of this here. I don't think it's going to affect us too much. Those are the air bleeds. Here's the hole for the air bleed in the top. So what you have is the air passing by here, creating a low pressure, because anytime you move air across an orifice, you create a low pressure. And the low pressure acts on this. You can see that comes right over to this. This is your... goes down in your fuel well after your primary jets. Your primary jets control how much fuel flow can come out of the bowl into this passage, which is surrounded by this. So then you have your air bleeds. It's in the can, so I can't show you the well. Anyway, both of these sit down in the fuel well. So as, since air is lighter than gas, it moves easier. Therefore, when you apply a low pressure to here, where it wants to draw the fuel up through here, it's going to draw air down from that tube. And that's going to put little air bubbles in here. And those little air bubbles are going to go through those holes and those holes. And what you're doing is you're trying to create foamy fuel, because foamy fuel is lighter than solid liquid fuel. Solid liquid? Then just plain liquid fuel. It's going to start atomizing. So it's easier to break up foamy fuel and create droplets than it is to have just a plain straight liquid fuel and break it up into droplets. So there's your carburation lesson for the day.
Into the bucket. Throttle. Nothing happens to the throttle plates. That's because you have a governor. So what the governor does is trick. Don't breathe that stuff.